we solved the structure of tRNA. Jane, by this time, John Robertus, a postdoc from the States, had joined us, and also Jane.
Jane Ladner,
yes, but she had her maiden name was, and she was really Jane Ladner by this time, yes. And she had, and she grew, she actually seen growing good crystals of full three-dimensional crystals of tRNA. Yeah. I think she was actually trying to grow a mixture, I mean, a tRNA with something else, but it's, what happened is one of the species crystallized out.
Yes.
She was trying to see interactions between them. And so John Robertus and you, John, solved the crystal structure, didn't you? And John Robertus, who'd come to do something else.
Yes, Roy Brownman, he was,
he had been trained as a psychologist, but he wanted to get into chemistry because he found psychology too frustrating. He was a very active fellow. And so the first crystal structure was published in 1974. Now, we were competing with Alex Rich, who was working on the very same species of tRNA. And he was a fast follower. And they had an orthorhombic form, we had a monoclinic form, which is simpler in some ways. Of course, there were troubles about the heavy atoms. I won't go into all the troubles, but it took until, I think Jane crystals were published in 1972, but it took till 74 to solve it. I won't go through all the technical details of that. The structure was a three-dimensional folded structure. It had all sorts of interesting non-Watson-Crick bases and so on. Alex Rich thought he'd steal a march on us. He published a paper of 4 angstroms some time ahead.
Yes.
And he totally misinterpreted the map. They because it was low resolution, because they didn't understand it, they actually were, the backbone of the molecule they traced went through certain base pairs. They got it all wrong. And our paper was right, but he managed to tell the world that they had done it at the same time, which wasn't true at all. There was a conference that went on in Madison and so on. Where I wasn't there, but John Roberts and Brian Clark were there, and they weren't quick-witted enough to see that what he was presenting was our structure, not his.
Yes.
Anyway, so there's quite a lot of quite a lot of unpleasantness in science. When I charged him with it on the telephone, he said to me, "I'm not a saint." He's not a saint. It doesn't mean to say you're not a sinner. Okay. Sung Ho Kim. Well, Sung Ho Kim, I didn't want to go into that whole story.
No.
Sung Ho Kim, or what had happened to Sung Ho Kim, they disagreed about the high resolution model. Sung Ho Kim actually got it right, but Alex preferred to, he had left Alex, but Alex had worked with a chap who went to Alabama, whose name I'll remember in a moment. And Alex published the wrong choice. They couldn't, the map wasn't clear enough to see the chain tracing, and they chose the wrong one. But it's really quite cunning. In the model, he shows that there's a certain base pair 1538, a non-Watson-Crick base pair. First time people describe these GC non-Watson-Crick. And I knew the model had to be right, because many tRNAs you had AT and GC, but never switched chains, so it had to be a non-Watson-Crick. Not like this, but like this. This is the glycosidic bond. So I knew that was right. I remember showing it to Francis. He said, "Oh, it must be right." But Alex, in the text, in the models he published, and then the text he says later on, it could also be the other way around, you see, covering his tracks. So that was tRNA.